students, good morning to all. Today we are going to learn the balance portion of the digestive system in humans. Digestive system in humans. In the last class we learn about the functions and the compartments of our alimentary canal, about the mouth and buccal cavity. Next we learn about our the food pipe, esophagus. Then we learn about our tongue. Then we learn about our stomach. Now we are going to learn next compartment of our alimentary canal. Next compartment of our alimentary canal. This is the next compartment of our alimentary canal after the stomach. Yes, the small intestine. The small intestine. The small intestine is a highly coiled long tube. Long small intestine is a highly coiled long tube. It has a length of about 7.5 meter. It has a length of about 7.5 meter. 7.5 meter. The small intestine is a long, highly coiled long tube and has a length of 7.5 meter. Then it is a narrow tube. The small intestine is a narrow tube. The small intestine is a narrow tube. The small intestine is a narrow tube. And which receives, the small intestine is an narrow tube which receives the secretions from the liver and pancreas. Once again, we learn about the small intestine. We learn about that another compartment of our alimentary canal is the small intestine. Long tube. It has a length of 7.5 meter and it is a narrow tube. It is a narrow tube which receives secretions from the liver and the pancreas. Which receives secretions from liver and pancreas. Receives secretions from the liver and pancreas. Then the wall of the small intestine also secretes digestive juices.
The food components are also absorbed in small intestine. The food
component. After digestion, the food components are also absorbed in small intestine. Okay, once again, about small intestine. Small intestine is a highly coiled long tube, has length 7.5 meter, and it is a narrow tube, and it is also a narrow tube which receives secretions from liver and pancreas. Then the wall of small intestine, secretes digestive juices. And inside the small intestine, complete digestion of food takes place. Inside the small intestine. Then and also the food component, after digestion, the food components are also absorbed in the small intestine. Next, the largest gland of the body. Which is the largest gland of the body? That is liver. Liver is the largest gland of the body. The liver is present, the reddish brown colored gland.
Bile helps
In the digestion of fats, the bile helps in the digestion of fats. The bile helps in the digestion of fats. Bile helps in the digestion of fats. The bile helps in the digestion of fats. The complete digestion of fat is done by pancreatic juice. The bile helps in the digestion of fats, but the complete digestion of fats is done by pancreatic juice. The complete digestion is done by who? The pancreatic juice. Helps in complete digestion of fat. Complete digestion of fat. Once again, liver is the largest gland of the body. It is reddish brown colored gland. Then the liver is situated in the upper part of the abdomen on the right side, and liver secretes the bile juices. The bile juices is stored in a sac-like structure called a gallbladder. Then the bile helps in the digestion of fats, but the complete digestion of fat takes place with the help of pancreatic juice. Then the pancreas. Pancreatic juice is secreted by which gland? Pancreas. Pancreas is a large cream colored gland. Green colored gland, which is located just below the stomach and secretes pancreatic juice. Which is situated just below the stomach. Pancreas is situated just below the stomach. Pancreas is situated just below the stomach. Once again, bile juice is stored in a sac-like structure called gallbladder. Bile helps in the digestion of fat. Then, the complete digestion of fat is done by pancreatic juice. Pancreatic juice is secreted by pancreas. Pancreas is a large green colored gland. It is situated just below the stomach. Then the liver is situated at the upper part of the abdomen, right side. Pancreas is situated just below the stomach. And the pancreas secretes the pancreatic juice. Then the breakdown of the complete digestion is done by pancreatic juice. Then the breakdown of fats into simpler compounds like fatty acid and glycerol. Carbohydrates into simple sugars and proteins. Carbohydrates into simple sugar and proteins into simpler amino acids. substances. Once again, the fat, present inside the small intestines is break down into simpler compounds. The breakdown of fat is into simpler compounds like fatty acid and glycerol. Fatty acid and glycerol. Carbohydrate into simple sugars. Carbohydrate into simple sugar. Proteins into simple amino acids. These breakdown of components is done by the pancreatic juice. This is a part of digestion. The breakdown of fats into simpler components like fatty acid and glycerol, carbohydrate into simple sugars, proteins into simpler amino acids. We learned that the small intestine, the wall of the small intestines produces the digestive juices. The intestinal juice secreted by the wall of small intestine. It also helps in the digestion of carbohydrates and proteins into simpler and water soluble substances. Then we can say that the food is digested. The breakdown of fat into simpler components like fatty acid and glycerol, carbohydrate into simple sugars, then proteins into simpler amino acids. Then the intestinal juices secreted by the wall of small intestine helps in the digestion of carbohydrate and proteins into simpler and water soluble substances. Now the food is digested. Do you all of you understood? Once again, inside the small intestine, the complete digestion is done by the pancreatic juice. And
the 7.5 meters. It is a narrow tube which secretes pancreatic juice, which receives the secretions from liver and pancreas. Then the wall of small intestine, it also secretes the digestive juices. The wall of small intestine is also secretes digestive juices. Then in the small intestine, inside the small intestine, complete digestion of food is takes place. Inside the small intestine, complete digestion of food is takes place. Then what we learn? We learn which is the largest gland of the body. Largest gland of the body, that is liver. The reddish brown colored gland, reddish brown colored gland situated in the upper part of the abdomen, upper part of the abdomen on the right side, upper part of the abdomen on the right side. Then it secretes, the liver secretes bile juice. Liver secretes bile juice, which is stored up. The secreted bile juice is stored in a sac-like structure called gallbladder. The secreted bile juice is stored in a sac-like structure called gallbladder. Then the bile helps in the digestion of fats. Bile helps in the digestion of fats, but the complete digestion of fats takes place is done by pancreatic juice. The pancreatic juice is secreted by the pancreatic gland. Pancreas is a large cream colored gland. Then the pancreas is situated just above the stomach. Just below the stomach. Not above, below. Just below the stomach. Then, which is located just below the stomach and secretes pancreatic juice. We know that inside the small intestine, complete digestion takes place. The pancreatic juice and the bile juices helps in the digestion for completing digestion. Then the breakdown of fat containing food into simpler compounds like carbohydrate, like say fatty acid and glycerol. Carbohydrates into simpler sugars and proteins into simpler amino acids. Then the wall of small intestine produces the digestive juices, which help in digestion of carbohydrates and proteins into simpler and water soluble substances. Now we can say that the food is digested. Then the digested food is absorbed by the small intestine. Next, how absorption in small intestine takes place? In the small intestine, how is absorption takes place? The digestion of food is takes place, then the digested food is absorbed in the small intestine. How the absorption is takes place? Then, first of all, the digested food, now the food is digested in the small intestine. Then the digested food is now passes into the blood vessels in the wall of the small intestine. There are lots of blood vessels are present. The digested food can now pass through the blood vessels in the wall of small intestine. This process is called the passing of digested food through the blood vessels present in the wall of small intestine is called absorption. What do you mean by absorption? Absorption means the process of The digested food can now pass into the blood vessels. In the wall of small intestine. Digested food pass into the blood vessels. Blood vessels present in the wall of small intestine. Wall of
intestine. What of small intestine?
This process is called absorption.
But you need the absorption, the digested food can now, the digested food is passed into the blood vessels.
Blood vessels in the mode of
blood vessels present in the mode of small intestine are called as absorption. This process is called as absorption. Then the inner mode of we know that the inner mode of small intestine there are lots of blood vessels are present. Then the inner mode of the small intestine have thousands of and also in the inner mode of the small intestine have thousands of finger like outgrowth. Thousands of finger like outgrowths are present. Finger like outgrowth is present, which is called a villi. The inner wall of the small intestine, there are thousands of finger-like outgrowths are present. That are called villi. These are called villi. What do you mean by villi? The inner wall of the small intestine have thousands of finger-like outgrowths are called villi. Then the villi. How the villi helps the small intestine for absorption? The villi increases the surface area. The villi helps to increases the surface area for absorption. The villi increases the surface area for absorption of the digested food. The villi increases the surface area for the absorption of digested food. Then each villus has a network. Thin and small blood vessels flows to its surface. Each villus has a thin and small blood vessels. Each villus has a network of thin and small blood vessels present at the surface of intestine. At the surface of the wall of small intestine. Once again. How the absorption takes place in the small intestine. The digested food can now pass through the blood vessels present in the wall of small intestine. This process is called absorption. Then the inner wall of the small intestine, thousands of finger-like outgrowths are present. These are called villi. The inner walls of the small intestine, thousands of finger-like outgrowths are present. That are called villi. Then how the villi helps the small intestine for absorption? The villi increases the surface area for the digestion of food. The villi increases the surface area for the digested food. The villi increases the surface area for the digested food. Then each villus has a network of thin and small blood vessels close to its surface. Each villus has a network of thin and small blood vessels close to its surface. Small
surface. Then the surface of the villi absorb the digested food materials. The surface of the villi. The surface. Each villus have a network of thin and small red vessels close to its surface. Then the surface of the villi absorb the digested food material. The surface of the villi absorb the digested food material. After an absorption, then assimilation takes place. Then the next process is the assimilation. Next process is the assimilation. Assimilation. What do you mean by assimilation? What do you mean by assimilation? And assimilation is the process. It's the process by which the absorbed food is taken into the body cells. The absorbed food is taken into the body cells. Taken into the body cells. And used for energy, and is used for energy growth and repair. And is used for energy growth and repair is called assimilation. Assimilation is, what do you mean by assimilation? Assimilation is the process. Assimilation is the process. The process by which the absorbed food, is digested food, absorbed digested food is taken into the body cells and used to growth, energy and repair is called the assimilation. Why do you mean the absorption? The digested food can pass through the process by which digested food is passed through the blood vessels present in the wall of small intestine is called the absorption. After absorption, assimilation takes place inside the small intestine. Inside the small intestine. What do you mean by assimilation? The process by which absorbed food is taken into the body cells. Body cells are used for energy, growth and repair is called an assimilation. Energy, growth and repair is called an assimilation. Then after assimilation in the cells, after assimilation in the cells, glucose breaks down with the help of oxygen into carbon dioxide, water and energy is released. Water, carbon dioxide and energy is released with the help of oxygen. Glucose breaks down. Once again about absorption in small intestine. What do you mean by absorption? In the small intestine, complete digestion takes place. After digestion, the digested food is passes through the blood vessels present in the wall of small intestine. Then in the wall of small intestine there are thousands of finger-like outgrowths are present. These are called villi. Then villi helps the small intestine to increase the surface area for the digested food. Then each villus has a network of thin and small blood vessels close to its surface. Then the surface of the villi, absorb the digested food materials. Then after absorption, assimilation takes place. What will be assimilation? Assimilation means the process by which the absorbed food is taken into the body cells and used to energy and used for energy. Then growth and repair is called assimilation. Then after assimilation in the cells, the glucose breaks down into carbon dioxide, water and energy is released with the help of oxygen. The glucose breaks down with the help of oxygen. digested food and unabsorbed food enters into next the undigested and unabsorbed food is enters into the large intestine. Enters into the large intestine. Next we move on to large intestine. Next we move on to large intestine. Next we move on to large intestine.
The remaining verse
place pass into the rectum and remains there as a semi-solid pieces. And remains there as a semi-solid pieces. Semi-solid pieces. Then the fecal matter is removed through our anus. This process is called ingestion. What do you mean by ingestion? The fecal matter is removed through the anus. This process is called ingestion. Once again, about large intestine. Large intestine is wider and shorter than small intestine. It has a length of 1.5 meter. The function of large intestine is to absorb salts and water from undigested food. Then the remaining waste passes into the rectum. Then the remaining waste is present in the form of semi-solid feces. Then the fecal matter is removed through the anus. Next we move on to digestion in grass eating animals. Do we know which are the grass eating animals? Yes, cow, buffalo, goat, etc. are grass eating animals. Then how digestion is taking place in grass eating animals? Do you see that the grass eating animals chewing continuously even when they are not eating? Why? Actually, they quickly, first of all, they quickly swallow the grass and store it in a part of the stomach called rumen. Digestion in grass eating animals. Grass eating animals like a cow, cows, buffaloes, and goats, etc. are grass eating animals. They chewing every time, even they are not eating. Then actually they are not eating. First of all, they quickly swallow the grass and store it in a part of the stomach called a rumen. What are rumen? The grass eating animals quickly swallow the grass. The grass eating animals quickly swallow the grass and store it in a part of stomach. These are called as rumen. Then, what are rumens? The grass eating animals chewing every time, but even they are not eating. Actually, they swallow the grass. Stored it as a part of the stomach. These are called the rumen. In inside the rumen, there is cellulose is present. So we know that all green plants cellulose is present. Inside the rumen possesses cellulose. Rumen possesses cellulose digesting bacteria. Cellulose digesting bacteria, which break down the food by fermentation. The rumen breaks down the food by fermentation. Rumen breaks down. Breaks down the food by fermentation. Once again, what are rumens? Rumens actually the grass eating animals swallow the grass and store it as a part of the stomach are called rumen. The rumen possesses cellulose. Rumen possesses cellulose digesting bacteria. Cellulose digesting bacteria, which break down the cellulose digesting bacteria breaks down the food by. Once again, digestion in grass eating animals. Which are the grass eating animals? Cows, buffaloes, goats, etc. are grass eating animals. These animals chewing continuously even when they are not eating. Actually, first of all they swallow the grass and they store it as a part of their stomach. So it is called rumen. Then inside the rumen there is cellulose digesting bacteria is present. These cellulose digesting bacteria breaks down the food by fermentation. Then the partially digested food, the remaining, the swallowing food is stored as a rumen. So that rumen is partially digested food. That partially digested food we call it as cud. So let's wind up the class. What we learned today, we learn about then. What are things we learned about? Small intestine, then large intestine, then digestion in grass eating animals. Then all are read the textbook more and more times, then study well. Thank you.